So, like most of us with childhood trauma, should be pretty much everyone in here. If you're sitting here tonight going, I don't think I have any, I had great parents, I had a good childhood, and this comedy show, it's not that fun for me. Good. I hope this is the worst night of your whole life. Because it sounds like it's been smooth sailing. And you might need some perspective. But most of us did have some childhood trauma. And when you get to be an adult, you're like, whoo, made it. Never have to think about that again. Look at all my keys. The world's my oyster. And so you just start pushing all that dark stuff that happened to you as a kid down, 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 until you don't even think about it anymore. And that works for a long time. Until one day, you stub your toe really hard on a curb and you just start weeping uncontrollably in the street. And you're like, okay, this is about something else. I was keeping all my trauma in that toe. And then I jostled it and now it's everywhere. Go back in. And if you don't deal with that stuff, it's gonna keep affecting you in ways you are not even conscious of. I realized in therapy that because my mom died young, I have this irrational belief that I am also going to die young. So I've been living in a very intense, unhealthy way my entire adult life where I'm like, I can't take a break. I gotta be working all the time. I have to hit these goals and achievements. Otherwise, I'm nothing. I got engaged a few years ago because I was like, I gotta get married before I'm dead, which is a super hot way to propose to somebody. I call it the walk to remember. It's kind of my move. And...